Welcome back to PJ Chain Design. I usually like to use Rhino to do everything as possible. This type of a shape is actually will be easier in the T-spline, but I just want to prove it. Rhino can do everything. So let's take a look on this Gecko and how do we work with the surface like this. Let's get started. There are a lot of images you can use as reference, just using the picture to bring it back to the Rhino. We want to be able to see clear, so you can go to the material here on the right button, and then you can lower the opacity, so that way it doesn't like be too strong of the color over there. And then we want to lock that layer and working from this layer. I'm going to change to the red color. It's easier for you to see. First of all, we're going to trace basic outline over there. So we're gonna coming over here. Don't worry about the eye. We're gonna get the body first. So we want to get something like this. And you can trace it, get it as close as your design. And I'm going to leave the button, the very end, open like that. And that's coming back here. I'm gonna keep tracing it. He has a really big head, and we're just gonna have something like this. Don't worry about the leg yet. We're going to trace them separately. So we're gonna coming over like this. And again, leave the button open, like very end open like this. And then you can adjust it and see if that shape is what you like, and by moving the control point. At the end, instead of to draw it, I would like to use the blend tool. I'm gonna blend it from here to here, so it's nice curve there. Let's go ahead to join all those curves here. I also want to make sure I do not have that point over there. So the best way to do is rebuild this curve. We want to rebuild into the last point, but this is too much of a deviation over there. So let me bump it up to 36 and take a look on that. Still, there's a lot of point missing. So I'm going to stay actually more than what the original is. And if that is too much of the difference, we can still adjust it later. But everything else will look fine over there. So I'm just going to click OK. And then we're gonna adjust it by this way, by moving this over here. And we may wanna adjust this point to get more close to the original design. You also notice after you rebuild it, it will be rounded everywhere, and this the point is kind of evenly out. All right, so this is what we wanted to get. The second things we wanted to do is the hand over here. The hand I'm going to do is having a line starting from inside of the body and coming over here to get something like this. I wanted this to be continuous and always back inside of the body. I'm gonna continue to draw the rest of the feet, so I'm going to speed up the video right here. Alright, so now we have all the feet there. That's starting building the main body first. I'm going to use the sweep. So first things, we need to find the rail. So it's gonna use the split command to split from there to there first. So now we have two rail over there. We're going to create the cross section. I'm gonna use the arc tool. We're gonna snapping into the near point from here to somewhere around here, and want to make sure that it going up like this. Let's do a test first. We're gonna do the sweep to rail 1 rail 2 with the point, starting with the point right here, coming to the cross section and ended up with the point one more time. Then we'll get something like this. If this is what you want, that's great. If not, you can keep edit until you get something that you like. All right, so let me go into lock this one. We are going to do the cross section on all of them. So let me go ahead to use the orient to point. We're going to snap into here to here as a reference point, and we want to have a copy, and we also want 3D scale. So let's have it coming over here on every single one. I got an extra there, that's okay, we can delete it later. and having one over here. All right, so you actually don't want this stick it out from the body, so we wanted to go select a top three of them and have them go down. As long as they are not sticking out from the body, you will be fine. So make sure they all stay inside of the body. Each of them is going to be built by the sweep tool. So we are going to pick up the curve and we are going to split with the point. And somewhere right here, gonna do that to all four of them with the point. Somewhere in the middle right here. And the very last one, we want to split with the point somewhere right there. So let's go ahead to creating the surface. We want to make sure that we use a sweep to rail, and that's a cross section. Before you finish, make sure you record a history, because that may not be the thickness that we want, and we can always change it later if we do record a history. So make sure that you record history on every single of them. All right, so now when we look at this, we might think about, okay, this may not be what I like, and I do want them to be higher, lower, or changing the shape or things like that. So I may, every time you move, you want to move all three together. Then you will get something like that, and then you can keep adjusting. Currently, they all surface right now. We can cap it later on, but I want to finish the whole thing first. So the first things we wanted to deal with those four tall over here. It's coming to the top view, and we're going to use a sphere. So I'm going to have my seam face up and kind of scale it down something like this, okay? And then we're going to tilt it in the way that fitting into the drawing. All right, so we got one there. We need to have all five of them. So I'm just gonna copy all of them first and make sure that you wanna rotate it so the seam is facing outside. So I got one things like this. And that's because we don't wanna cut the seam over there. Okay. So the next things that I wanted to do is try to do the bridge in between. And again, I just noticed this might be not be fat enough. So I might want to keep dragging the line until you like your design. So I want to kind of edit just a little bit something like this to make them a little bit wider. So that will look nicer. Okay, and then so I need to draw the section in between. So I quickly want to draw curve. It's gonna go inside of the body, the same idea with the one for the leg to the body. So we want to have this coming over here and this coming over here. All right, so once we have this, let me lock this one. And we are going to do some surface there. So I'm going to simply, again, using the arc tool, and gonna go from here to here and make sure they're going up. With the same thing, let me go ahead and use the orient to point. We're gonna have that one snapping into this endpoint to endpoint. Copy equal yes, we do want a 3D scale. And we want to go from here to here, here to here, and you're just gonna do a bunch of cross section. Here to here. Okay, so I just noticed those balls are not right at the same level. So just using the align tool to align horizontally to the zero. Okay. So now we got something like this. And I may want them to be a little bit skinnier. And don't forget to do the button. It will be much easier than do them separately. So I'm just going to create a line. I should have done that before I do the oriented to point, but it's only five of them. So I'm just gonna do something like this, and we wanted to join this and this one and become a closed curve. Alright, so let's give it a try. Sweep 2, rail 1, rail 2, cross section. So let's do the fillet edges. We want to pick up here, here, here. This is kind of a tight over there. I might also want to pick up this one, so we'll fit it all the way to the end. And then apparently this one is over that line. I just want to make sure it goes smaller. And let's give it a try. Alright, so now it's smoothed all the way to the end. We're gonna do the same thing for all rest of it. So I'm going to fast forward the video. So now we finish the feet, we can go ahead to bowling the rest of the body. To creating the eye, what we like to do is creating the outside shape. So I'm going to use the curve and to draw something look like something a little bit puffy like there. And I can make this two a little bit lower so they will look a little bit rounder. Something like this. And we're gonna simply just using the revolve, and we'll revolve this guy from this point to that point for 360 degrees. So we get this dish looking things. And I'm going to also using a sphere and kind of create some sort of sphere right there so you can get two surface right there. And I can make this one go up a little bit so that look like an eye or something. Now we can bowling this and to get this eye smaller and even smaller. Okay, so that would be the eye we want to play with, and I'm going to using the command orient on surface, and this is the guy I'm going to orient it on the bottom and to this surface over there. Make sure the rigid is not checked, and then we wanted to click OK. Make sure you wanted to have a copy. So I have one over there and the other one will be approximately right there. So now we got this one there. If it is too much outside, that's okay. We can simply just bring them in a little bit, or when you try to do the surface oriented, you might want to set up some sort of a reference point so you can get them a little bit lower. Let me delete this curve over here. Alright, so if that look alright to you, let's go ahead to bowling, and then having the eye stick it out that much is just weird, so let's give it a fillet edges on every single edge that we can find, and also on this one as well. So that will be the tutorial to using the Rhino to build this organic gecko shape. A big thanks to Karen Chartier. Thank you very much for your donation. It makes a huge difference to the small YouTuber like me that helped me release my other duty and create more video. Thank you very much. And thanks everybody for your watching. Please like and comment my video, and I will see you next time.